In this episode, we are going to understand the basics of HTML tags, what is CSS, how to use the CSS styles, and what is JavaScript, what is Bootstrap, and how to use the Bootstrap. We will implement all the stuff related to HTML, CSS, and Bootstrap by creating this web page. So the first thing you need to do here is you need an editor. So there are many editors available on the internet for creating the web page. The first thing which you need to do is download this Visual Studio Code. I am on the Mac system. You can download it for the Windows OS also. So download this and install this Visual Studio Code to begin your journey in the web development. Okay. So this is the first task you need to do. Download this. Now to create this web page, open the Visual Studio Code which you have installed. Go to new window here. You will see the screen like this, right? Here you have the new file. Click on new file, text file. Okay, you will get one file here, untitled one. Now go to file here, save this, or you can use the shortcuts here as well, Control S or Command S on Mac OS and Control S on Windows OS. So I will save this here with the name admin home. If you save it like this, that will be much better. Admin home.html. Every HTML file is denoted or stored with the .html extension. Similarly, HTML files have .html extension. CSS files have .css extension, and JavaScript files have .js extension, and TypeScript, which we are going to see in the advanced part, TypeScript files has .ts extension, like this. So you need to remember this extension before proceeding to anything. Now we need to understand the structure of HTML. Now HTML is written inside the opening and the closing tag. Okay, so this is a basic HTML tag. Inside HTML, we have the heading, all the colors, all the background colors of the web page, all the styling part, whatever the styling part and CSS part is to be written, is written inside this head tag. And we have the body tag. Now what body includes is, whatever you see on the web page, this is one web page, all the things related to the content of the web page is written inside the body tag. That is easy to understand, right? Now let's quickly create this heading. We have the admin login here. To create the admin login, we have the heading here. The first thing we are going to create is this heading, admin login. So for that we have used the h1 tag here. Okay, now similar to h1, we have 6 more heading tags. So let me quickly create the headings. This is h2, heading 3, heading 4, heading 5, heading 6. So we have the 6 types of headings in HTML. While creating this web page, we will cover all the tags which you need to know, so you have the clear understanding of all the tags, right? Heading 4, heading 5, heading 6. So here we have heading 2 tag, heading 3, heading 4, heading 5, and heading 6. So to run this now, reveal in Finder, open this in browser. This is one way to open this. Or you can also do this, click here new tab and drag this here, so, and enter. You can also open this file like this as well, right? So we have heading 2, heading 3, heading 4, heading 5, and heading 6. Like this, you can see the difference here. This is the heading 1, first one. Every time we increase the number of heading, the size of the heading is getting smaller, right? So we have these 6 headings in HTML. If you notice here, we have some spacing from the top here, right? From here as well, and from here as well. So how to add the spacing, that's what we are going to cover inside our CSS part, right? Before that, let's create the text boxes here. how to create the text box, and we will create one link here and the button here, right? And this checkbox. So let's first quickly create this basic stuff and then style the then we are going to style everything using CSS, right? So heading is added. Let's add the input box now. Enter your email. So to add the input box, all you have to do is use the input tag like this. Input type is equals to text. Let's run this. So we have the input box in our web app. This is a input box. Now inside this, whatever is written is called as a placeholder. So the placeholder here is enter your email. For that we will add enter your email. If I run this now, you can see enter your email placeholder is written. Now if I type something here, like for example teamcodesify@gmail.com, that placeholder is gone now, right? The enter your email placeholder is gone now. So this is called as value. This part which is written is called as value, and if the value is not written, the placeholder will appear so that user know what to type in the text box. If I do not give this, there will be, if I do not type anything, there will be confusion like what to type here. Similarly, if I create another box for password, there will be two boxes, so user do not know what to type in these text boxes. So we have to apply the placeholder properly. Placeholder, enter your email in the first box, and placeholder, enter your password in the second box, like this, right? Now if you notice here we can add the Gmail ID, but here if I add the password here, so the password is visible here, right? But the password should be like this, they should not be displayed. So to add this functionality in your web app, you can use input type is equal to, instead of text you can use the password here. So type is equal to text will create a text field, and type is equal to password will create a password text field. Now if I type here, so that password will take as a disk format, the encrypted format. Now to bring it on the next line, we want input text on the one first line and the password on the next line. For that we will add the break tag. Okay, we will add one more break tag to add more spacing, like this. So we have admin login, two text boxes. Now we want this anchor link, forget password. To add the anchor link in your website, you can use the A tag, forget password. We have the forgot password here. Now this link is not clickable here, right? To add the link, click here. Like if I want to click here to apply the link here, you can use the href attribute. Here you can type your forgot password functionality link, like whenever user clicks on this link, which page you want to open to let him to enter the new password. So this will be the forgot password link. Now you can see at the bottom here, you can see the URL where this page will redirect me. If I click here, I will be redirected to the codesify.com page, right? You need to add your own forgot password page. So this is how you can add the link to your web page using the href attribute. Now one more thing you need to understand here is these are called as tags. This input is a tag, this input is a tag, this h1 is a tag, a is a tag, body is also a tag, html is also a tag, right? Everything inside html is a tag. Now after html tag, whatever is written is called as attribute. This type is an attribute, this type is an attribute, this href is an attribute, and this text is its value, this password is its value. Type attributes value is password, href attribute value is this URL, and these are called as tags. Okay, now we have the link here. Link is on the next line, so let's break this as well. So we have the forgot password link here as well. Now we have the we have this checkbox here, remember me. So how to add that checkbox here? type input, type is equal to radio, or we can use checkbox, and the name of the checkbox is remember me. So as you can see, we have this input type is equal to text will create text field, password will create password text field. Similarly, checkbox will create checkbox for us. Like this, we have the remember me checkbox and the link as well. We will style this part. First, let me create all the stuff. Here we have button on the next line, sign in button. So how to add that button? For that, we have the button tag. We have the sign in button tag, but this is on the next line. So let's add this break. Every time you have to use the break to add the new line, right? Here we have the sign in. Now the color here is black, and also the width of the size and the width and the height of this button is different. And here we have the basic button, right? Sign in with Google. We have one more button, sign in with Google, like this. Okay, and this is also on the, this is also in the next line. So we have the break tags. Here we are. Now we have the don't have an account and this sign up link. So let's do this quickly. This is a paragraph. Now paragraph tag will help you to write the paragraph in your web app. So here we can use don't have an account question mark, and we need to add the link as well. So for that we need a tag, right? Sign up. And to give the link, you have to use the sign up link here. Give the URL where user will sign up, like this. Don't have an account, anchor link, sign up. So we have this. Now here on the right side we have one image here, right? And on the top here we have one logo. Logo and this image. So how to add the image tag, and that too on the right side. For that we have image source attribute, and give the path of your image here, and here we have our image. So as you can see, nothing is displayed here. Why? The reason for this is we haven't specified the path here. So let's add the image here. So that is the image we need to store here, right? For that, let's first quickly create one folder here, right? We have this adminhome.html saved inside this folder, right? So I will create one folder here. I will give it as basics of web course. I will give the name of the folder as this and copy this inside basics of HTML. So this file will be removed from here. I will close this, go to the file here, new window, and open that folder which we have created, basics of web course, inside this. Drag and drop this folder. Let me again tell you the steps. Wherever you want to store your web app, create new folder there, name it, whatever name you have to give, name it. Drag and drop this folder here, web course, you have that adminhome.html, click here. So the project is properly set up now, right? Previously what we have done is we have created only adminhome.html file. Now what we did is we added this file into one folder. Okay, so we have one folder now. Now we can easily manage all the tasks related to our web app. So I have the image ready here. I will drag this image into my project, and here we have genzschool.png. That's it. Give the name genzschool. If you notice here, if we add some files here, we can automatically, Visual Studio can automatically detect all that files, right? We have the genzschool.png here. Save it and run it. So as you can see, if I am running this, this file is stored inside this, right? But now we have created another folder for that. So for that purpose, you have to again go to the Revelin Filer and open this file. We have our image ready and all that login information. But if you notice here, image is on the right side here, and the form is on the left side, and there is also a logo here. So let's quickly add one logo as well. So after body tag here, image source, and you can here add the logo as well. So I have the logo also ready. copy that logo into your project and add the path of the logo here as well. So we have the logo ready as well. Next thing which you need to do is set the height and width of this logo. I will give it as 40 and width as 40. So this will minimize the logo size here, as well as for this image as well, we will set the height as 320 and width as 320. So these are the attributes, height and width, and 320 and 320 is its value. Source is an attribute, this is a value, and this is a tag. So we have the image smaller than before. You can adjust the size according to your UI requirements. This is the basic UI which we have created. I hope you are getting the basic understanding of the tags in HTML. Now what we will do is we will apply the CSS part today. Let's start with this button. Now here we have the black button, and here inside our project we have the gray button. So to add the color to this button, what we will do is we will assign it a class attribute and give it name as button sign in. You can give any name, right? But you have to use this name here as well. So inside the head tag here, give dot. Because this is a class attribute, you have to give the dot and the name of the class name, right? This is a class name, and add the curly brackets. So here we have the button, and we have to give it a background as black. Now let's run this. As you can see, the CSS part is not applied here, right? We have added the background black, and also we have assigned the button sign in class name, but the style is not added. Why? Because we haven't added the style tag here. Make sure inside head tags you have this style tag. In that you have to assign the color and the styling part. So we have the black button ready here. We want the text color as white. So for that purpose, we have to use color as white. Like this. Now from all the sides here, we have to add some spacing. Spacing means there is some space, right? So we will add 20 pixel spacing. So you can use this padding property, and this is a value, right? With the help of this, you can add the spacing in your buttons. If you have noticed here before, we have only this part. Now we have added some spacing from all the sides. This is a left, this is a right part, this is a top, this is bottom, and this is left. From all the sides, 20 pixel spacing is added here, right? Whatever the number you will give to the padding, that much padding will be added here. For example, if I add 40 pixel, so you can see this is 20 pixel. For 40 pixel, the amount of spacing from all the sides, from here, right side, from here, and from here as well, all the sides have 40 pixel, right? So what we will do is we will give 10 pixel padding. So from all the side we have 10 pixel padding, but if you notice here inside this, we have the 10 pixel padding from the top and from the bottom, but from the left and from the right we have more spacing. So how to do that? For that, all you have to do is assign padding left as 30 pixel and padding right as 30 pixel. So from top and bottom it will take 10 pixel, and from left and right it will take 30 pixel. So here we have bigger button. Now let's add more spacing, 60 pixel, so that we have much like this, right? Here we have the corner radius. Here we have the borders as rounded. The box is not like this, box is like this, a rounded box, right? So for that you have to use the border radius. Border radius as 10 pixel, like this. So with the help of this, you can add the rounded borders like this, rounded corners. Now if I zoom this in, there is unnecessary border added here, right? There is a gray color border. I don't want to add that gray color border here. So to remove this border, what you have to do is set border as none. Border none. So the button will be plain now. So here we have a clean button now. Let me remind you all the stuff which we have done in the CSS part. First we have added the class attribute and we have assigned one name here. And after that, inside head tag we have added the style tag, and inside that style tag we have this class with the help of this dot. Whenever there is a dot, that means there is a class associated with that, right? Name of the class and the styling part. The background will set the background, color will decide the text color of the button, padding will add the spacing from all the sides. If we want specific padding from left side, we can use padding left, and for the right we can use padding right. You can also use padding top and padding bottom as well, but that is not necessary here. Border radius will add the corners, rounded corners from all the sides, and border none will remove the border from the button. Next thing which we want is, we want the input text field to be proper here. So here we have some padding, right? From all the side we have better padding, and the border here as well is different. So for that purpose, what you have to do is, this is our enter your email text field. Give it a class name, email text field. You can give it any name, but you have to use this here properly. Inside style tag, give dot and the name of your text field, email text field, and assign the brackets. So to add the padding here, padding means spacing. So to add the spacing, we will use padding as 20 pixel. So here we have 20 pixel from all the sides, from the top 20 pixel, from the right, from bottom, and from left as well. So what we want is, there is a less spacing from the top and bottom like this. And if you notice here, enter your email is bigger in font, but here there is a small font written. So for that purpose, you have to use font size as 15 pixel. This is a bigger font. If I write 12 pixel, so as you can see, enter your email is smaller now. Padding is more here, so we will give it 6 pixel like this. And we have the border as 1 pixel solid black. So we have a thick border here, right? But the border here has the rounded corners, but we don't have that. So for that, we will use the same property, border radius. If I type border here, you can see all the properties related to border is appearing in Visual Studio. So that is the best part and the benefit of using the Visual Studio Code Editor. We don't have to remember, only type border, click here border radius, and give it a border radius as 6 pixel. So it will round the corners. Here, if you notice here, inside this border tag, there are three parts. I have given this 2 pixel border, and the color of the border is black, and there is this solid black. Now if you want to change this, you can do this as well, 20 pixel border like this. The border is more thick now, and you can change the color as well here, from here like this. And if you want, instead of solid, we have dashed border as well. So this will create the dashed border. Dashed border means like this, you have this dashed border. So instead of this, we will use this solid. That will be much better. And the background and the border color should be black. Okay. Similarly, for password text field, you can apply the same class as well. So email text field has the same design. So for the password also, I want the same design. I don't want to change it. So you can give it as email text field only. So the class name should be same if you want the same styling for multiple elements. So we have the input, enter your email and enter your password, right? So here, if you notice, I have created only one class here, email text field. Now I have assigned the styling part to this text field, right? But what I want is, I want the same style for the password text field as well. And if I create any other text field like enter your mobile number, there also I want the same styling. So for that purpose, you can use the same class name in all the text field. Like for enter your mobile number as well, you can use the same class name so that all the styling part will be written here. So you don't have to repeat the stuff again and again. You can use this name here as well. So how CSS will work here? CSS will check like wherever the email text field is present, where it is present, here, and if I create one more text field like enter your mobile number, there as well, it will check here email text field is present here as well, then it will assign all the CSS part here, right? That is how CSS works. For example, if I have the button sign in here, so it will check inside body tag where button sign is present. If it founds button sign in is present inside body, it will assign the CSS to that button. Like here we have the button sign in, so it will assign the style to this button. If I want the same style to this button as well, like this sign in button, we can assign it the same class name here as well, like this. So that button also get the same styling part. But in our case, we don't want the background color to be black in sign in with Google button, right? So for that purpose, we have to create a new button here, Google sign in button. Create a new button here, dot the name of the button, name of the class name, and we want background as white and the color of the text field should be black. We want border to be thick with a solid black color. So let's add that quickly. Border 1 pixel, I will give 2 pixels solid black. Like this. And we want it to be the border radius of 6 pixel. So this will add the border radius to all the sides. Now we want a padding or spacing from all the sides, right? Like this. So for that we will add padding 10 pixel, right? Padding will be added from all the side, but from the left side and from the right side we want more padding. So for that we will add padding left as 60 pixel and padding right as 60 pixel. So here we have a bigger button here. If I reduce the size here to 40 pixel from all the left and right, that will be the button, right? Now what I want is, I want this image to be on the right side, right? So there are multiple ways to add this image to the right side. So the better way to add the image on the right side is to use the Bootstrap class, right? Now what Bootstrap is, type Bootstrap here, get started with Bootstrap. Copy this link Bootstrap, and inside head tag we have this, right? Inside heading tag you have to add this Bootstrap. I will send you this code in your mail ID so that you can refer the code and create your own page as well, right? So you will get this link properly. For now just use this to understand it better. Now what this styling part will do, these are the Bootstrap links. This is a .css file and this is .js file. So this is created by Bootstrap developers so that we don't have to write the entire stuff again and again. So I will show you the better example here. For example here, for button sign in we have added the black color, right? For button sign in we have added the black color with the help of this property background black. If I remove this and remove this color as well, you can see the color is now gone. With the help of Bootstrap class, what we can do is, inside the class attribute here only, after button sign in you can write bg dark. Now bg dark will do all the CSS part automatically, like this. It will change the color automatically. Similarly, if I write here text white, so this will change my color automatically to white. If I want bg success, so my color will be changed automatically. Similarly, we have bg warning as well for orange color. we have one danger class, BG danger. This is a red primary, like this. We have blue color. If I want secondary, can use the secondary color as well. So we have these properties, BG dark. Let me write it for you. BG means background. So you can, with one single word, you can assign the color to that, to any element of HTML with one word, just by adding these two lines. You don't have to write the color and all that stuff here. That is the advantage of using the Bootstrap. So we have the background color as dark, BG as success, BG as danger. You can try this out on your own so you have the better understanding. BG warning, BG primary, BG secondary. Similarly, this will set the background color. If you want the text color, you can use the same text dark, text success, text danger, text warning, text primary, and text secondary, like this. So if you notice here, all the right hand part is same here, only first background or text, that's what you have to decide. We have given the text as white here, right? Background as dark. You can choose any of these based on your UI requirement. So we have the background dark. If I want this as green color, I can use success, text success, like this. Okay. Similarly, here as well, for sign in with Google, we will remove the background color and color property from the styling part, and we will use that here. So we will use BG light and text as dark, like this. Okay. So we have sign in with Google, sign in button. Now we want this image on the right side. So for that, we have the better approach to write the things, right? So let me introduce you with the concept of grids in Bootstrap. So we have type div.container, like this. So it will create this snippet automatically. What you have to do is type div.container and press enter. So this will be created automatically for you. Inside this, create div.row, this will be created automatically. Now div.col large 6. Similarly, type div.col-large-6. So if you notice here, we have one container. Now what exactly is container, that we need to understand. So we have this container tag here. Inside this, we have row tag, and inside that we have two columns, 6 column each, right? So from here, from this side, from here, from left till right, we have 12 columns, right? Each column is divided into parts. Now from left to from right, everything is designed into 12 columns. So what we are doing is we are dividing that 12 columns into 6 parts. So half part will be taken by this 6 column and half part by this 6 column. So let me show you. Whatever we have written here, the half part will be added here and the image will be added in the other half. Let's run this first. So as you can see, the half part, 6 columns are taken by this part and the 6 column is taken by this part. So we have the total 12 columns web page. Similarly, what you can do is you can create as many columns as you want. Let me remove this. Similarly, what you can do is you can create 4 columns here for the first part. Let me type h2 here, first part of 4 columns. Similarly, 6 parts for second column, 6 parts for second column. So the total here is 4 plus 6, 10. Now we have two columns left, so we can use that as well. Div dot call large 2. So total you have 12 parts. You can use it anyway. I can use this 2 parts for third column like this. If I run this now, you can see the first part is of 4 columns, second part has taken much space, and the third column has 2 parts. If you want to see this properly, I can give it a background color as primary for the first column, a success with middle, and the danger in the third column like this. So the first part is of 4, 6 part has been taken by this, and 2 parts by third column. If you notice here, a spacing from left and from right is added by default. So to remove this spacing, what you have to do is, we have used a container here, right? Add container dash fluid instead of container. So the space will be removed from both the sides. So this is what you have to understand. Once you got this basic knowledge of Bootstrap, you can create any web page within 1 hour, right? So that is the basic part you need to understand. All you have to do is install this Bootstrap using these two links inside head tag, and after that create one container and row. Inside row, whatever columns you want, you can create based on the 12 columns effect. So if I want two columns here, so we have 6 columns. We can create 6 more columns like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like this. So based on your styling part, you can give it. I hope you got the basic understanding of Bootstrap, how this works. So for now, we want only 2 parts. First column will be of 6 column and second will be of 6. In the first column, we want a logo, a title, 2 input text field, 1 remember me text box, checkbox, and this button and this link. And the image part will be on the right side. So that's I have added inside the second column like this. And we will remove the spacing by adding. See, here there is a space, here there is a space. So we have to remove that using the container fluid. And I will remove the background colors inside my column so that we have clear understanding. Let's keep it container like this. Now we want to add some spacing from the top to the left column, right? Here for the admin login, let's do this quickly as well. Here, give it a name, heading, title. Give dot name of the heading title and padding top as 120 pixel. So this will add the spacing from the top 120 pixel here, right? Similarly for the image as well, we will add the spacing. So where is image? This is an image, right? Here we will assign a class attribute with image. So let's add the spacing to this image as well, like this. So either you can use padding top or you can use a margin top as well, like this. So what is the difference between padding and margin now? So we have two topics now to discuss, padding and margin. We will explore each and every property which we have seen. Like this is called as a property, this is called as a value. So we will see all these topics one by one in as we explore more in our projects. So this was a introductory lesson how to use and how these things are created in the HTML, CSS and Bootstrap. So things which we have to remember is the Bootstrap class, the styling part which is written inside the header tag, and the basic properties which we have used right till now. So here we have container, row and 2 columns, 6 column each. In one column on the right side we have added one image, and on the left side we have added this form, and using this class attribute we have assigned the CSS part here. Now as you can see, admin login has more spacing, so adjust it properly. Give it as 100 pixel like this. Now, if you notice here, don't have an account is of less font size. Here we have smaller font size, right? So do that stuff as well. Assign class here. This is para. Give it name as para. You can give it any name. Dot para. And give it as font size 12 pixel. So what the CSS will do, it will search for para class inside body tag. Where is para? Here is para is available here? No. Is available here inside class? No. Wherever para is available here, it will find class as para. So this part will be assigned with this styling part, font size. So here we have don't have an account with a smaller font size. Add some breaks to have spacing properly. Here. Like this. Similarly, remember me and forgot password has smaller font size, but we have much bigger here, right? So for that purpose, we have the checkbox. Give it as a class. Check. Dot. Check. And give a font size as 12 pixel. So here we have. And here as well, give class check, so that we have the check class is for assigning the font size, right? So the same class is applied here. Here the font size is smaller, but here the font size is not getting small. Why? Because here we have the remember me without any tag. So for that, you can use the span tag here. Span tag, use span tag here and give a class as check. Instead of giving it in input tag, this will not work in input tag. You have to assign the span tag here, then only it will work like this. And between these two, I want some spacing. So for that purpose, you can add NBSP like this. So this is how you can add some spacing between the two elements. Now, if you notice, the width of the input box is bigger. So let's do this as well. Email text field. Assign width as 200 pixel. So we have the bigger text field now. 220 pixel. That's much better, right? Sign in button has much spacing, so let's adjust that as well. Padding is 5 pixel. Here as well and here as well. In both the buttons, you have to adjust the spacing like this. And give width as 200 pixel. Give the width as 220 pixel like this, right? Here on the top we have the logo. Let's add some spacing here as well. So from top, give it as a class logo. Give it as a dot logo, and instead of padding we will use margin top as 20 pixel. So we have the spacing for the logo as well. I hope you got the basic understanding of how to create the web pages like this. In the next episode, we are going to explore all the CSS properties and the basic difference between like padding, margin, relative, absolute, all that stuff we are going to explore in our next episode. So for now, your task is to create this web page. Okay, I have sent you this on your email ID. You can create this web page admin login on your own, and also I will send you this code so that you can refer the entire code and create the web page on your own. Try the basic stuff on your own, and in the next episode we are going to explore the different CSS properties and values, and also Bootstrap classes. If you have any doubts, you can ask me on this email ID and on WhatsApp also. Thank you for watching. See you in the next episode.